friends, welcome back to Pragmatic Lopa. Wondering how to add a cool yet elegant look to your couch? Or redecorate your house that would go well in any season? In the easiest and most inexpensive way? Then you are at the right place. So let's take a sneak peek. In today's DIY, I'll show you using fabric, how you can make easy no-sew pillows or cushions. And in one, I'll also show you how you can even sew,
for those who are interested,
for which you'll need fabric and insert pillow or pillow fillers and a hot glue gun or needle and thread. Basically, I'll show you two ways. One is standard throw pillow and the other is envelope or pillow sham, which has an opening in the back to slip cover easily whenever required, which I prefer. Along with many other variations, today I'll show you six different types of pillows. Cushions or pillows come in all different shapes and sizes, which at times can be pricey to buy at stores. This way it can be so inexpensive depending on the upholstery fabric you choose to use, which would be easily available at any fabric store. I got mine from Walmart. You can check out fabric at the clearance section for a great deal. So let's do it.
For making cushions, you can either repurpose old cushions to give it a better look or use your foam fillers, or buy new insert pillows or foam fillers, all up to you. And need some basics like measuring tape, hot glue gun and scissors.
For the first one, I tore apart the cover so that I can use this thrifted cushion as insert pillow, and also bought this amazing soft fabric. Measure the pillow right across on top, which in this case is 18 by 18 inches. So after adding an inch to it, mark the seam on the fabric, that is 19 by 19 inches, as extra will be used on either sides for gluing. Make sure the fabric is smooth. Now cut it along the marking using scissors. Now you will have two square pieces of fabric, front and back. Sandwich the fabrics with right sides together facing each other and wrong sides up and down. Now carefully apply glue along the borders on all the three sides, leaving only one side to insert the pillow. Flip the cover right side out and pop all the corners out using your fingertips or any pointed object. Now carefully insert the pillow, and it's time to seal the fourth side. Fold the fabric almost half inch in and close it using hot glue gun, and your cushion is ready. For the second one, I'll use this dirt cheap 70% off even on thrifted cushions, which costed me just $1 each. This green cotton fabric and this white transi fabric to lay over green for a different look altogether. As it's cotton, iron before starting. Make sure you remove all the creases in the portion you'll be working on. These cushions are of the size 15 by 15 inches. Now repeat the entire process I mentioned before. Here you can see I used bamboo skewer to pop the corners to have nice and neat corners. Once you have your cushion ready, now you can use it straight away, but I added a variation here by adding one more layer to it. This fabric had frills at one end, so as to include it, width was same as pillow plus 1 inch extra for gluing, that is 16 inches, but length I extended till the frills. After closing all the three sides using hot glue, insert the cushion and be creative to try out any way you like. These are simple rectangular cushions which I made in the similar way as green. Only difference here is there's no variation added. You'll need just an insert pillow and fabric of your choice. Now that you have seen how to make a basic throw pillow, let's make a pillow sham or an envelope pillow cover, which is as easy to make as the basic one. In fact, it's my preferred one, as you can change it whenever you are bored of it or take it off if you want to wash it in the washing machine, convenient to done and off. For this, I got this ultra baby soft material. The front piece of pillow is same as we did before, that is add 1 inch to the size of the pillow, which in this case is 19 plus 1, that is 20 by 20 inches. But for the back piece of pillow, we'll use 2 pieces of fabric as they'll overlap each other slightly. Let's do a simple calculation. Unlike the front piece, here once dividing the original pillow length into 2 parts, we'll add 2 inches to the length of each piece. 1 inch for gluing and other 1 inch for overlapping. So in total, length will increase by 4 inches. Now place both the back pieces with the correct side of fabric facing down. Make sure the measurement is same throughout. Now with the help of any such long pins, pin all the pieces together. Make sure the borders are in line before pinning. After gluing all the borders with the hot glue gun, remove all the pins. Before turning the correct side out, trim the corners a bit, cut diagonally, which will make it less bulky and corners will be nice and neat. Do this for any type of cushions you make. Flip the right side out and poke all the corners out like we did before. Insert the pillow and your envelope pillow is ready for use. For the amazing fur pillow, which comes in tons of colors, I picked this white one to match all other pillows, and I also got this thrifted pillow measuring 19 by 19 inches. Either you can directly insert this pillow into the cover you make, or you can tear apart the pillow and use its pillow fill. Unlike to the new pillow fillers, which are well separated, here they will be packed tightly, so you have to loosen them before further using for your pillow. Like you can see here, the saleswoman has hacked up the fur too short as she went deep in there to cut instead of just the back. There are few tricks you need to follow while handling fur, else the fabric will have bald spots. By cutting this salvage air, which anyways we won't be including for the cover, I'll show you how you can cut fur. Instead of straight away cutting all together including the fur, cut only the thick back part. This way all the fur will be intact and won't cut short. Measure the fabric 1/2 inch more than the insert pillow. In case you are using one, mark using a pencil and cut it along its marking using pair of scissors. Now you'll have 2 square pieces. In the same pillow, I'll show you both how you can make it without sewing using just hot glue gun and also hand sewing using needle and thread. First, bring all the fur inside and align the borders, both the fur sides facing each other. Pin them so it becomes easier for you to work on. First, I'll show you using hot glue gun. Remove one pin. Make sure all the fur is still inside. Apply glue directly along the border without leaving any side gap. That's why, unlike the previous pillows where we measured 1 inch extra, here I measured just 1/2 inch. And glue them together. Keep repeating the entire process along all the 4 sides, leaving only a small gap of 6 to 8 inches on one side in case you are using pillow fillers. And if you are using an insert pillow, glue 3 sides, leaving only one side to insert pillow. After gluing, flip the right side out, insert the pillow, and in the same way, seal it using hot glue gun. Else by using needle and thread, which is sturdy and easy as well. Same as before, keep all the fur inside and pin them. First, simply push the needle through the fabric. Again, push the needle through the fabric, but now pass it through the gap formed by the thread and repeat the same stitch known as buttonhole stitch. Stitch all 4 sides, leaving a gap of 6 to 8 inches at one side in case using pillow fillers. Consider it as the 2 borders of fabric. For better understanding, I am showing you the same stitch I did on fabric on this black paper for better contrast. Hope this makes it more clear. At the end, make a knot. Everyone has different way of ending a knot. What I do is wrap the thread for 3 to 4 times at the tip of the needle, pull it up, again push the needle through the fabric and pass it through the gap formed by the thread and cut it using scissors. Flip the right side out. Make sure to pop those corners out as well. Start filling in with the pillow fillers through the gap. Make sure the corners are filled properly to give it a complete fuller look. Now for closing this opening, keep all the fur out of the way. Start from one side of fabric, push the needle inside out, across to the other border, pushing the needle out to in. Keep repeating till the end and make sure all throughout you detangle the fur, some of which might get stuck in the process. At the end, secure it with an ending knot I showed you before, and your baby soft fur pillow is ready. For the last one, I took this rectangular thrifted pillow 15 by 12 inches and used one of my scarf which I made many years back. You can also use whatever is available at home, like your old t-shirts, sweaters. If you are interested, I can show you how to make this in some other video. For now, I'll use a scarf to wrap the pillow. Make sure you wrap such that the stitches should lie at the sides and leave equal length of fabric up and down along the length of pillow. As I don't want to spoil my scarf, I'll sew it using needle and thread instead of hot glue gun. Now stitch along the width, back and forth like I'm showing you here, and for the length too is the same as running stitch. And at the end, to secure, make a ending knot as shown in the previous one. Once finished, you have your choice of cushion ready for use.
Now that you know what has to be done, you can get creative with whatever is around you. And if you like this video, give a big thumbs up. Hope you'll recreate some of these soon. And don't forget to tag me in those creations. It would mean a lot to me. Please subscribe if you haven't already for more such creativity. And do comment your views. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, take care.